bit of a, I'm gonna have you zip me up, please, Cody, the rest of the way. Now, yeah, this is not actually a fashion suit, right? This is called creativity, which runs rampant at our practice. And this is a Halloween suit, okay? But that was, now the reason I didn't put on that like red suit that Cody was holding with the muscles on it, I want to take you away from looking at things that way. Because when you look, when you magnify fascia, right, this is like what we're used to, you know, the muscle dude or the muscle girl, right? When you magnify 25 times, when you look underneath the skin between the muscle and everything, it looks like cobwebs, literally, okay? And if you've ever prepped pork tenderloin, or if you've ever, right, that stuff that you're kind of the silver skin, and it kind of, sorry, if anyone's vegan, I apologize, but it, that ripping, that's what it is, like this cobweb stuff, okay? So this is if my suit is doing fine, like look, I have range of motion, everything is fine, I can move, right? We're gonna start with a simple demonstration and then take it a little bit more complex. So Cody, you're gonna come over here to start. And Cody's gonna give me a myofascial restriction at my left armpit area, lat area, ribcage area, okay? Now, I might not know that I have this, and I'm gonna go have an x-ray and go have an MRI, and it's not gonna show. But all I know is that I can now, shoulder impingement, frozen shoulder, rotator cuff, bicep tear. This can create all sorts of stuff. Because I'll tell you what, if I've been trying to move, and it usually doesn't happen overnight, like maybe it started like this, and then as it got worse, it just got like reduced my range. And every time I go to move my arm, I'm actually straining through tendons, ligaments, bones are now sitting next to bones, creating bone spurs, and maybe tearing things, okay? Now, there is someone in this room that actually had this situation, had their shoulder replaced, and in her words, after the shoulder replacement, when she came to see me still, every day when she tried to wash her hair, it's a functional movement, yes? Just to wash her hair, she would be crying from the pain. This was already replaced. Beautiful, they did a beautiful replacement. They never corrected the restrictions around it. She was still straining through her muscles and her nerves and everything. So now Cody, let's say, does a fascial release over here, and all of a sudden, I've got full range of motion. I have people with full rotator cuff tears to the point where they were told this cannot be repaired. They now have full range of motion because we freed up the structures around. This is the brilliance of the human body. It doesn't just rely on one or four little muscles like the rotator cuff in there. If you free up other things, it'll figure out a way of doing it. It's absolutely brilliant, okay? So this is rather obvious, okay? Let's make it less obvious by giving me a right hip restriction. Good, so, dun, 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 dun. Good, good, right hip. Can you see that I've got some shoulder issues going on still? I like the wall I just saw. Because when I look at people, I no longer look at where they're telling me they're hurting. I'm like, what is, where is this going, right? So, can you see now, by the way, I'm gonna try to walk, Cody's gonna stay because that stuff doesn't let go. We've seen this walk before, okay? Now, so the truth is, because the knee is a slave to the hip and the ankle, I might have a knee problem. Because this is pulling and I'm maybe compensating, I might have a knee problem or a hip problem over here. And I now, like, my neck is not moving as well. I'm not putting the hoodie on, I'm not doing it, okay? So that is really important. Now, I want you to picture, I've got this restriction and this restriction. The important thing as therapist is we don't release the wrong one first. Because if I release this one first, this is a line of pull. This is active. It'll actually just pick it up. I like that face you just made. That doesn't sound like a good plan, right? So it's very important to know where to start to release someone. So we would definitely start here, give them more material, get rid, okay, this area is doing well. Then we would release, and then boom, that person has range of motion, okay? Now we're gonna make it even less obvious. Cody's gonna give me a calf restriction. It's gonna look pretty. Good. And this is what I visualize when I look at people sometimes. Again, they might have a hip problem. They might have this hip that's doing all the work. Can you see that I still don't have very good range of motion in my shoulder? Or I might start to do this to be able to get my arms up? Can you see that now I can get it, but if I stand up straight, I have a restriction? Okay? So I'm gonna try to walk with this. And again, we've seen variations of this, right? When you start to see the side to side and all this, And I might completely tear out this hip or this knee or this hip. How about my low back, do you think? I dare anyone to go for a walk with this in a suit that's restricted down there and have, go for like a half hour walk. Tell me how your back feels. Okay, with Cody hanging back. Okay, so Cody, now grab that and do me a favor, grab that. Again, the order of things is going to matter here. Because guess what? Do I stand on my hip or on my leg, right? That's the foundation. So the first order of business would be to release the restriction there, actually. Can you see already how this literally just improved by that? It's very visual, I love this suit, okay? And then if Cody starts to release this, and then we're gonna release this, and all of a sudden that person now doesn't have a hip issue or a shoulder issue. Okay?
So you always release from the ground up, right?
Absolutely, yeah. Foundation. If you're going to, we are an arc, great question. This is just, I'm gonna call upon your common sense, and I'm also gonna say that we follow results. Okay, so I can have a fancy opinion, right? And every specialist you go to, we all think we're right. I mean, on a good day, otherwise, please, what are we doing? We're only right if we deliver results, okay? But yes, this is an architectural structure. If I have a neck issue or a shoulder issue, that is the equivalent of a roof or a second story issue. Please don't hire the architect that starts to fix from the roof if this is happening, right? You gotta look at what's happening down there right now that's causing this. So yes, it's always from the ground up. It's how we're designed. And that is the amazing part. When you start to do that, it's just incredible the results that we can produce. As I said, ultimate optimist, still incredibly pleasantly surprised, shocked, amazed by people's capacity to get better. At some areas where we didn't even realize, we've had people with severe facial pain. They didn't come to see us with facial pain, okay? I want you to picture this suit. It's all attached, I'm not gonna know, okay? It'll look real creepy. And they came to us for a hip, the hip got better. By now, I track everything, we track. Anywhere you've got that sensation, guess what, that went away. But, okay? I'm gonna give you one other example, Cody, you will have to free me out of this, because this is the thing, I do feel a little restricted in this, okay? So it's not that much fun, especially after he's pulled. It's like I can feel everything doing it. Now, by the way, I'm going to present something. This suit, really good demonstration of this, right? Mm-hmm. This was woven by, you know, fabric, right? So that basically means that these are pieces that were woven together, little threads, right? These threads never knew each other. What does she mean by this? Okay, you started out as one cell, the proliferator. And then specialized. If we think it's not connected, okay, and it's not some esoteric, oh, it's all connected. No, it's very literal. It's all connected, and you are a closed kinetic chain. And if you've got an issue here, usually it doesn't also happen. In fact, someone comes to me from the shoulder, and I'm like, how's your head? Yeah, you know what, it doesn't feel great. I'm pretty sure it doesn't. You know, I do have a little bit of plantar fasciitis. Okay, it's like Sherlock and Watson when we first worked together, where you're getting, by the way, I'm not sure if you're Sherlock or I'm Sherlock.